everybody, welcome to another episode of On the Paint Table. This is my weekly show about what I got worked on, what was finished, and what's coming up. So this week I painted some more stuff for my JSA for Infinity. Got through eight more models. I did some rebasing on some old models, and I also painted a whole bunch of terrain. I finally got to actually cracking open my terrain from Shadow War Armageddon and getting it painted. So I'll show you what I got done and what is coming up. And so here's the finished pile. So we'll start with the JSA. I finished off my last two Domaru Boutets, which is the Spitfire and boarding shotgun miniature. Meaning I have two sort of like just wielding swords, can be anybody's. And then two that are sort of just fire team members. I painted my Tankos, who are super fun. They remind me of the Thunders from Big Trouble in Little Chinatown, which is my third favorite thing about them. And they have like just hilarious weapon loadouts. They all have monofilamental weapons. One has a missile launcher. Most of them have Blitzens or like weird ARO things. And they're just awesome. And they can form a fire team either with Domarus, or you can take them with Musashi, and I'm going to paint my Musashi just to try it out, because it's just so silly that it is amazing. I painted my two Yowzows, so I have two little helper bots, and because I'm working on heavy infantry, it seemed like an appropriate time to paint the Doc, which is the Toketsu Butei, I think they're called. But don't quote me on that. I want to paint the Engineer next, probably, just in case these guys get EM'd or immobilized or sticky gunned, as Owen is wont to do. And then I went and worked on, this is actually one of my Shadow War Armageddon warbands. I went and built a new team leader for them with Power Sword, and rebased them all on 32s, because they're all on 25. So I originally built this for Kill Team in 5th edition? 40k like ages ago, basically when this box came out. I just wanted an excuse to paint, as you do when you do these little skirmish games, these awesome models from the 6th edition, because it was 6th edition was when this box set came out. And these Chaos Space Marines are the way I wish every Chaos Space Marine miniature looked and should look. So when they redo the Chaos Space Marines eventually, they need to make them look like these guys, because these guys are just amazing Realms of Chaos Space Marines, and I will collect enough someday that I will have a whole Night Lord's army just based on these guys. So I made a Night Lord Sergeant, so my Claw has another Sarge now. Mr. Power Axe is no longer in charge. Mr. Power Sword is. He was like a Dark Apostle, I think, in that box set with the Dark Angels. And I just rebased all these guys. It was nice because I used epoxy sculpt to make the mounting on them. So I literally just popped them off the 25s with a knife. And then stuck the 25mm bases on there and threw down some Astro Granite to give them some texture and stuff too. So Night Lords are ready to rock and roll. People always ask how I paint these. They have the world's simplest paint scheme. They are primed black, dry brushed with Lead Belcher or whatever the iron one is, Ironbreaker. And then the panels are all painted inside afterwards. So I paint like the actual like colored panels inside the trim with Incubi Darkness. And then the whole thing is given a light edge highlight with Ultramar Blue, I think it is now called. and then the details are done like the metal, the golds, the browns, which I think all my browns are not Mournfang. No, maybe it is Mournfang Brown. Yeah, Mournfang Brown, I think, and then washed all over with Bataille Black. And then I just go on and do all the highlights afterwards. So it's super simple. It's like, it's a really easy color scheme to do fast. And the skin tones are done with Demon and Hide, blended up with some, I think, Althuan Gray mixed into it later on to give that sort of like Nostromon sort of paleness. And then the eyes are actually just painted black with a highlight of Sibrite Green to give them that like glowy black eye thing. So only one actual new miniature there, but I figured I'd show it. I'm matching all the bases on these guys for those of you who remember them from the Shadow War campaign. And then I painted up some stuff. Speaking of Shadow War, I painted up my Shadow War Armageddon Sector Zo. Sector Mechanicum? Sector Mechanicum. I can't remember what all these things are called. and these are also cheap and cheerfully done. So it's going to look more complicated than it is, but these are not even painted with an airbrush. These are painted with rattle can paints. Which is to say like big like spritz paints you can get at the hardware store. So I started off, I primed these with a Tremclad, Red Oxide primer, which is just a generic primer you can get for like $6-$7 a can. So everything here is primed with that, and that gives you that nice red, earthy, rusty undertone on everything that you see here. And then the sort of techie bits, I used another Rust-Oleum chalk paint. It's this nice, vibrant sort of like teal. And then another chalk paint, which was like gray, and I just sort of zenithly zapped it. I just wore a
a latex glove, I was gonna just get my hand clean. I just sort of zapped it from on high to give it that nice sort of texture, and then everything was dry brushed with some, and then this one was done with a leather brown over top of that same chocolate color. And then I just gave it all a nice beige dry brush and then picked up the details, and that was it. Like, this stuff is super easy to do. Super duper easy to do. This was a trick that we used to use painting tables for like Throne of Skulls or Games Day or stuff like that. This is a John Schaefer special, I would call it, for those of you who remember John Schaefer. And yeah, these are super fast to do, and they look great, and I'm super excited to use them actually on the table. And then these down here are actually, they're not from the Shadow War box. They're resin GW Terrain that used to be sold in stores back when I think Cities of Death came out. I just found a package of it. I was like, wow, I have this? And so I figured I'd paint it up too and have some barricades, have some like actual like stuff. And it's really nice. It's got like a crash bike, which I just picked the details out afterwards, right? So it's like a crash-based marine bike there. There's some little consoles and stuff, right? Some like broken in doors. And actually this all matches the old modular Cities of Death train from Cities of Death. So like it's all in the same style and stuff too. So there's some more train pieces I painted up. I felt like doing some training when I get on a roll with train, it's easier I find. I hate assembling train, but it's easier I find to paint a whole bunch of it at the same time. Because you kind of just do broad strokes. And so I did all this in a day. Like it was already built, I primed it because it was super hot out, and then I just painted it all in a day. So 19 miniatures this week, plus some rebasing. And then 12 pieces of train. It's not too bad. 9, 12. Here's some upcoming stuff pile. I'm super stoked about this. Sorcerer 3 and the Manowar crew. Let's make Manowars great again. I'm going to paint Sorcerer 3. She's the latest incarnation of the flagship. She was the original Kator Warcaster from the original Star Set. And now she's wearing Manowar armor. So like in a total 180 from her speedy zippiness, she's now slightly speedy and zippy, but wearing a Manowar suit. And then I've got the Commandant Atnes, Arkonovich in standard, which weirdly isn't a unit attachment, it's a unit by itself of two guys. And I've got Dragor, whatever his name is, Sergeant Dragos Dragotovich, who's the unit attachment for, my unit of, what are they called? The Demo Corps, the guys with the big hammers. So, I'm pretty stoked about it. I've also got my Forge Lord all airbrushed up there to get ready to rock and roll, and I'll get these guys painted for my next game War Machine. Whenever that happens to be, but I'm pretty sure to try the Manowar core. I don't have any of the new big guys, but these guys are enough for me to give it a shot. And I do have a bunch of Manowars, of course. I have like the Dracoon and some regular Manowars. Although it's a min unit because I have the original unit of it painted up. I need a Demo Corps to give it a try. And then I've got some Kurnoth Hunters picked up for my Sylvaneth to finally break from. Although I'm excited to be like able to summon spam Dryads now. I do need to paint up some more Dryads. These guys will get painted when I paint my next batch. Basically, I'm gonna paint another Tree Lord Ancient, another batch of Dryads to have like a summoning pile basically of them, and then these Hunters will be my next thing I add to my Sylvaneth army, and I'm pretty stoked about it. I'm tell me in the comments what I should build them as. I'm tempted to build them as the guys with the bows, but the guys with the swords and the Reapers look so cool too. And then the only thing I picked up so far to add to my my Soul Wars stuff is this unit of Sequiturs, just so I can paint the rest of the Sequiturs that came in the box. And I'm holding out for the unit of Evocators, like the easy to build Evocators, so I can finish my Evocators unit too, because I really want to try them because they're awesome. But there's only three. So I'm actually thinking I'm actually just going to paint these two because they've changed the War Scroll. The War Scroll that's on the site actually makes it 2 per 5 now for the Grand Maces. And you can break that with the Grand Mace on the Sarge as well. So I have the Sarge of the Grand Mace unpainted. I have another Grand Mace and another guy with Hammer and Shield. So I can make another 5 Sequiturs. And I'll still have an extra person. So I'm going to leave this. She's too cool to have just be, I think, a prime. I want to make her into a character. So I'm actually probably going to keep that miniature and convert her into a character at some point. Because she's just super cool. And I really like her. I really like her, like, just her sculpt. And I'm really hoping that these end up being alternate somethings for whatchamacallit as well for Shadespire, because I really like the miniatures. So yeah, I'm gonna paint them up, and I'm pretty stoked about them. So that is my stuff that's coming up that I haven't built yet. And then down here I've got the rest of my JSA. So we've got the ninja division, which is Cytotogan and 3 ninjas. I have the ninja everything. It's like the hacker slot, just the one with the sword that you use for every profile. Tacbo, and then over here is the sniper, and they'll be painted up so I can do my all Teo camo spam. I just need to find a Shinobu because I couldn't find one in stock in Canada. It's just like, you can find a miniature market in the States, but there's like, I'll literally pay for her 3 times. Like I pay for her shipping her, and then I pay customs at the border. I ended up paying like $35 for like one miniature. I'm not going to do that. So I got to try and find one in Canada. It's out of stock right now in Meeple Mart. And then I've got my Kurogi Rider. I've got Mr. The Man, the Legend right here. Miyamoto Musashi, I'm going to paint up to go with my Tanko. It's not their painting because I'm stoked about that. And I gave him, of course, the Tanko hat because, like, why wouldn't you? And then the rest of these guys, my two last Kasetsos, the missile launcher and the combi. I think I showed you guys this last week, but I couldn't remember, so I just doing it again. My Spec Ops guy, my Tuketsu engineer, and then my Kempe with a, I think it's a boarding shotgun. I'm actually not sure what it is. I think it's a boarding shotgun. I think it's supposed to be a boarding shotgun. And we're ready to rock and roll. So yeah, so that's the stuff that's gonna get done. I'm actually really excited to have this JSA stuff finished, because then I can move on to another army for Infinity. But like, it's like, when I get on a roll of stuff, I need to finish, because if I stop, these will never get painted. So I'm going to try and finish these next week. Hopefully I get all this stuff done next week. And there's the stuff that's coming up.
So there we go, another on the paint table on the books. If you want to see what I painted next week, of course, tune in on Saturday. And until then, I'm Ash. God forgive me. I hope you enjoyed that video. If you want to support the channel, of course, like and subscribe and hit the little bell below so you get notifications when I post future content. I do post stuff 7 days a week. If you want to support the channel further, you can, of course, buy a t-shirt through Spreadshirts, buy a measuring gauge or objective markers from Deathrite Designs, or, of course, most importantly, there is Patreon. Patreon is what makes all this possible, keeps the lights on, pays for the studio costs, pays for the equipment, model costs, and everything else, and most importantly, puts food in my kids' bellies and a roof over their heads. Big thanks to everyone, past, future, who supported me. I do this stuff because of you guys, and of course, I will continue doing it as long as I can.